Every keep moving. Watch us get fucking bosoned on this gate.
My sides, dude. Just imagine.
打开了，又打开，你开，通过，等我命令。我把对面机枪抓住。炸弹队，别跳，后面别跳，炸弹队，后面的，不用的，别跳，别跳，后面的。 不用，不用点，你往上打掉，他们炸弹队都是肉，没有炮的。
OK， 所有人开炸弹，开。
点名，往外拉，开炮，开炮，开 ADC 往外拉。点要求，九个后勤的。
对，点要求。
第一目标地，第二目标地，第二目标K。谁给他们人跳哪儿？
那个小张，你能跟对就跟，不能跟对就滚。如果你死了，推舰队到 O3换船，再加上。
你闭嘴，要不然我会把你踢掉。
哎，我只能说傻逼。
All right. Oh, I just see the chat is a little bit far up. There you go. That video kind of makes me want to play with sound, to be quite honest. It kind of sounded awesome. All right. Little introduction, I would say. We had Fulcrum on already not too long ago. And as people might have just noticed, but also didn't know, he is actually also Rooks and Kings. He is an AOM, which is Army of Mangos on Tranquility. And then he is the leader of PIBC on Serenity. So like, how many things can one guy do, right? It's like a lot. So last time we spoke, actually, wait one sec. So last time we spoke, it was actually the beginning of the whole coronavirus bullshit and so on. It all started back then, or like actually it was already going on, and I hope you are doing well. But there's also other things that have changed in the meantime, which we will talk about. We had a really long conversation, but I had to cut it short because of an op last time. And so I'm glad you could make it today. And I know it's super early for you. So thanks a lot for actually staying up. I thought you're gonna wake up because it's so early, but you actually stayed up to make it. So thanks a lot for making it. And yeah. Welcome.
No worries. Thank you for inviting me again.
So like I said, leader of Mangos, leader of PIBC, then also involved with Rooks and Kings, which probably, I mean, at the moment doesn't add that much more work, but in general, right? I know, for example, one of the reasons why you actually staying up is your girlfriend's getting her wisdom tooth removed. So it wasn't that, like, there was another reason for it. But, like, how is she dealing with a guy that's so obsessed with this game, right? Like, you must have no time at all left, right?
No, not really. Actually, I spent lots of time with her. So, especially on Tranquility, there are not too many works for me when I have a good crew. And there's only two groups I need to watch out nowadays. One is Initiative. If you guys ping Fleet, I need to watch out. The other one is Norris. If he ping something like bombers, then I need to go back to, you know, go back to work. Otherwise, I just, you know, AFK and do something with my girlfriend, you know, have some good dinner with her or something like that. So she's all good with it. We have been together for like 10 years now, I think.
Well, that certainly helps, I would say. And I do remember, though, I forgot what it was. And I think did we talk about it on the last one? I do not know exactly. But I think we talked about that, like, my right hand is Ari, who's a girl. And you said, like, your girlfriend would be, like, annoyed by that. I found that quite funny. That your girlfriend wouldn't allow you to have, like, your right hand needs to be a guy, right?
Yeah, all my crew are guys, basically.
Well, it is. It is Eve after all. Like, it's not like my Corbo Alliance is full of girls.
Yeah, there are two girls in Mango Command. One who never talks, and the other one is a girlfriend of the other FC. So.
Yeah, you know what? In my opinion, like, just team play wise, like, just in a, you know, just in a team, from a team's perspective, I think girls or women, they're way easier to handle. They're way easier to work with, right? So, I don't know. I mean, this is weird. Like, this is not even on the list. I don't know why I'm bringing this up right now, but it is kind of interesting, I feel like. And that's an observation I did, like, while ago already, right? There's like usually maybe it's an ego thing, I don't know what it is, but I feel like it's way easier to work with girls, like in a kind of like in a supportive role or in any role actually. But
I think so too. I always have this question. The Elo Knights,
I'll tell you,
right hand is Doom Bunny, right? Is a male or a female?
Doom Bunny is a male. I had him on actually.
Ah, no.
But so Elo's other right hand, like usually
Tiana.
Exactly, I would say Tiana was his right hand too. She actually joined my corp not too long ago because Elo went inactive. And now I believe she doesn't have as much time for Eve. She's doing like study stuff and so on. And she basically, when she joined, she actually told me, if Elo comes back, I'm gonna, you know, go back to Black Legion and stuff like this. So I expected her to leave right then, but she didn't have the time to commit to like Black Legion and so on. So she decided to stay actually, which I'm super happy about, sure, because she's super helpful. She knows all the Russian players, for example, like not just Russians, but like whenever anything Russian comes up, like I know who to poke and ask about it. And you know what, I had her on once in an episode about support FCs, and I think I'm gonna have her on again for like a Logi FC episode. And maybe now is the best time, because just recently with the changes to resists and stuff, And the lodgy, I don't want to call it a lodgy nerve. It's, I don't think most people will even notice a difference, but, you know, technically, they talked about lodgies being touched, you know, passively, or what do you call it? Around the corner, kind of, you know?
Yeah.
They affected, at least. Yeah, so there's going to be an episode coming up with Logi FCs, I'm sure. Maybe the next one, actually. Or, actually, the next one, I already have someone, but maybe the one that after that.
Okay.
But, yeah. But how's life? How's life in general? Like, when we last talked, like I said, when we last talked, it was like this whole thing with coronavirus and stuff, and your town is close by to Wuhan, right? So it was like for Europeans and stuff, for us it was just starting. For you guys it was like really going on there, right? So
yeah, in China it feels like everything's over now. The coronavirus is all gone for the most of us, at least. I think everything is go back to normal. The university is reopening, and we just need to, you know, have a QR code if we want to go anywhere. So if anyone near you are, you know, infected, your QR code will turn into red. Then they will not allow you to go in any kind of public place like a plaza or whatever. Well, otherwise, if you have a green QR code, you are good to go anywhere, you know, you want. Of course, I'm still in uni, so it's a problem that they don't want to. I need to report my location every day so that I'm not in anywhere that's dangerous. So yeah, it's a bit odd for me, but basically in China, the coronavirus are all gone, I would say.
Well, that's good news. I mean, that's also good news for us to know, like, this is going to end at some point, at least, you know? I mean, some point in the future, hopefully. I think
yeah,
we kind of got lucky over here, but, you know, there are some places where it gotten really crazy, but it's getting better, I think.
Yeah, it is. Even in Wuhan, I just read the news that all the critical cases are gone, so everyone are fine. I think there's no severe infected people anymore. There's no one in ICU anymore, even in Wuhan.
But did this thing, that's a thing that comes up all the time. Did it maybe help Eve a little bit to get those numbers a little bit up? I mean, for sure the gaming industry profited, and I'm sure some numbers went up. Like, how much? You know what I mean? Like, that's the question, actually. It's not like if, but how much did it help the numbers go up? And I mean, in my opinion, it's not like the only reason why numbers went up, but I certainly know a couple of people that had more time because of it, more time to play Eve, at least, right? Would you, like, did you have more time to play Eve, actually? What do you think?
I spend every minute that I, you know, stay at home to play Eve. I think you can notice that from the MER report from the February and March, right? So most of the region that Chinese lived are on top. For example, the Kobe Edge, right? Oasa and Omist. These three regions are mainly, you know, mainly Chinese community are there. So I think these three regions are on top five. So five regions on top, one is Delft, and three of them are Chinese regions. So as you can see that, right? And for example, on Mango's comms, back to the old days before the coronavirus, it was like 200 people, 300 people there. During the coronavirus, there would be like 400 or even 500 on comms. So you can feel how people, you know, how it affects people in Eve, that everyone just stay home, you know?
Yeah, you know what? I mean, obviously, I've been hunting all this time, especially in your time zone too. And I've been hunting VVV, I've been hunting Fraternity. I've tried to hunt you guys, but god damn it, you guys are fast to roll every wormhole. So I felt like I could tell just by the numbers in space that, you know, things are changing a little bit. And that there's less people in space now, rock and mining and all that stuff. I think I can tell, but then there was changes implemented to the game too. So like how hard, like how much is it actually affected by the development, the real life stuff, you know? I don't know. I don't know. I can just take a guess, you know. But yeah,
Yeah,
if
I
you
can
say,
feel it. I
yeah.
can feel it. When I ask ping a fleet in the afternoon, I can get 100, during the coronavirus. But now, well, if I'm lucky, I can get 50. So you can,
Yeah.
yeah, do that.
Then maybe also because people were locked up and they couldn't get out for a while, maybe now that they can again. Then it's like for the first while, it's gonna be a little bit more crazy to the other side, right? Like the pendulum swings to the other side now, that people have way less time for Eve than they would normally have. And then maybe it's
Yeah.
not back to normal in that case, you know what I mean?
Yes, it's getting crazy here. Like the job, some people lost their job because their company bankrupted, and many people are trying to get a new job, and something like that. Yeah, people are trying. Many of my core members have to spend time in real life. Back to the old days, I always say there's nothing, in real life, not many things in real life could, occupy your time to play Eve. Most of them are just excuses. Like, if you're during a war, then you suddenly, something in your real life happened and you can't play. And the majority of my people would, suddenly get something happen in real life. But when the war is over, everyone come back. So most of it is just excuses. But nowadays it's not really excuses because I can see they don't even log in the chat software anymore. They don't really have time to chat nowadays. And they give me a time, like, okay, I will be back in July. I will be back in June because many projects that have to started now. So yeah, the coronavirus is probably over in China, and I think you will experience that in a month or so, that people would leave Eve for like quite some month to catch up in real life.
Yeah, I think that makes sense. Right. So let's see how it works out in the long run. Right. I feel like I saw a lot of old players return because they suddenly had the time. Like at least like a handful of really old players that just, you know, checked in. Like, what's up? What's going on in here? Right. They're looking for like, I mean, so Eve is a super social game. And like at the core of it, it's a hardcore PvP, but also social game. And I believe that like a lot of old players came back looking for that like old social group they had and just checking in on them because they have the time suddenly, right? So I hope that at least a couple of them will stick to it again, especially since I believe some good changes are in the making, right? So the whole coronavirus thing is one thing, but I think also Eve is going in the right direction at the moment, which like I like that I can be positive for once, like real positive about the future of the game, and I feel like probably old players can tell too that it's going the right direction, and yeah, let's hope they stick with it because we
Yeah,
need more players.
exactly. We are doing it all right. I think most of them are right. I mean, the HP of Supercarriers and Titans nerf is too heavy. I mean, for me, it's a bit
Oh, you
heavy
think?
because it's a bit heavy. I think probably just give it. You need to give it back somehow. Like the Jazz will be too powerful. No one would ever use supers again, I think, if in current situation. And
I don't know. I think I disagree because, I mean, look at it though. If you have enough EHP for the super to survive the initial drop. Right? And you have faxes that can save it. Like it's like with the current meta with Alpha. If you're not getting wiped off the field and you can be held by faxes to a degree, right? There's gonna be still situations where you can field them. You don't think so?
yeah, there are some problems with that because okay, so currently, Onyx would have like how many? 15 million EHP, right? A Titan. I log in my Serenity Erebus. I think he's not slaved. I think he only has 15 million EHP. So what does that mean? Back to the old days on PIBC, we all use X-type tank on Apostle, and with medium slave, mid-slaved, you would have 10 million EHP, I think, more or less, with all the boosters, of course, roughly, and overload, roughly 10 million. So basically, two Apostles would have more EHP than the current Erebus now. So I feel, you know, a bit naked with it.
You know what? I think we can live with it, right? It's like, that's the thing though. The patch aims at, if you field a ton of stuff and hostiles field a ton of stuff will die, right? And then they don't want all the stuff to die on one side, which I much appreciate, right? Like what we don't want is like 100 people on one side, 100 people on the other side, and then by whatever, even if it's skill-based, 100 versus 100, come on, give that other side at least something. You know what I mean? Like, they need to be able to kill something. If they don't kill anything, like, I don't think that's good gameplay. So, you know, if you drop 100 jets, you will kill a good chunk of supers. No matter how big that group is, you're going to kill something, right? Something significant, let's say it that way. Like, you could always kill some faxes, but who cares about that?
Yeah, so. I fully agree with you, but it was like the blackout. They let the hunters go out, right? They make the hunters comfortable, but the prey are not. So there won't be any prey anymore, right? During the blackout, I think if we last for another 3 months, you will find no rocos, no supers ratting, or rarely anyone are ratting out there. So you put risk too high and the reward is too low. Why would I drop my supers fleet? I can always drop jets, right? I can drop jets with hall guns. What's the difference with a jet hall gun and a Titan hall gun, right?
Well, you can kill jets. Yeah.
Yeah, I can drop like 50 hall gun jets, right? What can you do? I think basically nothing, right?
I mean, set on that, but yeah.
Will be hard, at least.
It will. Right? It will not be easy, but like certain doctrines will trade well against horde rats, definitely.
Yeah, I think CCP is aiming to let people trade, but I think probably it's only my opinion. Okay, they put too much risk on supers and titans and fewer rewards on that. That's only my opinion.
Yeah, you know what? I agree that how the game is at the moment, it might be too much risk, because I would like to see more supers and titans in space, definitely. But the game would have to change so they have a little bit more reward, right? And I think they're looking at that. How do we bring supers and titans into space? And I think like having like a specific site or something that might just be worth it, right? Don't let them get like super rich, easy peasy, like the bosoning havens, right? I don't like that kind of stuff necessarily, but like if they get like a decent tick out of their super or titan, I'm totally fine with that. Like, why not, right?
Yeah, so, I'm totally fine with it. I'm just afraid that no one would take out their shiny titans to do anything, you know.
Yeah,
like for example, in Ormist, we banned like when was the patch? I can't remember. A week ago?
Yeah, right? A week ago or something.
We have banned super threatening for a week now. So you can imagine.
We introduced them yesterday.
Yeah, like that's the easiest week for me on Tranquility, because there's no super carries out, there's no rocos out, so there won't be any green light. I don't need to worry, initiative will just suddenly, visit the Ormist and I have to defend my people. I can just, I don't even need to log in if, easy life.
But at the same time, I do see, like, we killed a super yesterday, I believe, that was ratting. The thing is with supers, their goal was always, don't get caught. If you get caught, even with EHP, you would die most of the time. Like, nobody is going to react in time if there's a couple of dreads on you or whatever, right?
Exactly, yes.
If they're fully tanked, then yes. Like, there's certain groups, it's very hard to kill the super in time. I mean, we did kill a super on your Keepster grid, remember? It's like, yeah, not too long ago. That was lucky as shit, but we got it killed and got kind of away with it. I think we lost a shit ton of Kikis still, but, you know, it was worth it.
But, yeah, it was. It was a good fight. At least a good entertainment for both sides.
Yeah, but that dude would have died faster. But at the same time, like, it was possible to kill them before. So the number one key for supers has always been don't get caught. Like, don't get caught in shits, like, in bad spots. Right? Like, in your little haven, that's a bad spot to get tackled in. Right? So, I think it hasn't changed all that much in that regard. Like, if you get caught in your completely no tanked hell, it's the same. Like, for example, that super that we killed yesterday, that Nyx, it was completely no tank. It only had a damage control. So it has the same tank as it would have had before the patch. So the difference is like zero, right? So,
yeah,
so I think it's still gonna have supers redding. I would love to have more targets, obviously, as a hunter, but yeah, maybe that's coming though. I think they're looking at that. I'm pretty sure they are.
Yeah, I think so. I think so too. And yeah. There's a good thing. You just said that there will be bots in the havens, right?
I didn't say anything about bots.
Boats, maybe. I just want to mention this interesting topic, if you don't mind.
Yeah.
Back on Senarity, there is absolutely next to zero bots exist on the server now. There's 20,000 players on the server. Of course, you're gonna ask how do you know that there's no bots there, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here's the interesting thing. So, CCP created a software that could automatically scan your computer memory, which would spot all kinds of botting software. Of course, you can make a new one and make it cannot scan it, but CCP would find it later on and add it to the I don't know how to say the database. Then they will ban you. So as long as you open up any kind of software that's related to bots, they don't care if you have used it or not. You get banned automatically. Of course, you can, you know, appeal it later on, but no one really are, according to the, you know, Chinese CSM, Senarity CSM, there's no one is, blamed for nothing. So you can feel how it is. But, you know, because of the privacy stuff, Tranquility probably will never have it.
Yeah, I was about to ask, is that the reason why we will not get it? Yeah. That might just be, because reading my memory, I'm not sure if I like that idea. Right, but yeah, in China it's a different rule set, huh?
Yeah.
But I guess that's good to hear. I mean, you know what would be funny? Now suddenly people realize there's no bots on the Chinese server. Everyone's switching to the Chinese server because there's no bots. Like, what a weird development that would be.
Yeah. You always go extreme in China, right?
I guess, but then also the number you said, like 20,000 players on that server, that's quite a lot. But just the Chinese server?
Yeah, you have to note this. There's not yet any new players in it. It's all old players. So it has stopped recruit any fresh blood for 2 years. And the NetEase will open up the new player to register the game in 2 days, 27th April.
Oh, I had no idea. So you couldn't even create new accounts for EVE on the Chinese server?
Not yet, yeah. Not
in the last 2 years? That's craziness. I didn't even know.
Well,
in 2 days, it's going to open up again.
During the last 2 years, it was done. The server is totally done, so you can't create any new accounts.
Yeah, so all these 20,000 players are all old players. Which is, that's mind blowing. I didn't know. I honestly didn't know. So it's gonna be, like, are they hyping it up over in China? Are they like putting this big date out there? Everyone, welcome to create a new account on this day.
And yeah, next week it will start. They will start to, you know, hype people next week.
I mean, they should already have started hyping people, right? So are there, do you think there's like a wave of new players coming in?
Yes, definitely, I would say. They say they were trying to get like 500,000 new players in, but I doubt how many of them was.
I mean, that's the thing though. So if you have 500,000 spread over, let's say like a year long of EVE, then I would argue they wouldn't see that it's a different story than if you get 500,000 players within a super short time span. Because one of the big disadvantages of EVE, or not big disadvantages, but the big negative points people would bring up that would look into getting into EVE, is that there's so many players that have already played for years and years and years, like decades, and they will never be able to catch up. But in that case, it would be way different. Because suddenly there's only 20,000 players that are old players and 500,000. You're saying 500,000, but I'm not sure if I believe that. But let's just assume it's 500,000 players coming in. Then most players are actually on the same level. So that plays way less of a role, right? So suddenly it's a completely different ball game. So
yep.
That's interesting. You know what? I always thought about like Project Nova, or like maybe Dust 515, right, if you want to call it that. I don't know what they're gonna shoot name the shooter, but if that shooter was like a massive success, like that would be a dream, because that would get a wave of new players into onto the Tranquility, right? And I always thought if that wave is big enough to like you have the same effect, that the new players don't feel like they have to catch up, but they're riding this wave of like a shit ton of people that are on the same level. I was thought like that would be epic.
And, but for example, Mangoes, we come over, you know, you guys have like 14 years, like, right? 15 years ahead of us, right? Yeah. But we start from absolutely zero. But I would say where Mangoes are doing really great in OSEC, right? Even in all these old giant, among all these, you know, old giant alliances, I think Mangoes is doing great. I think many people think, you know, Mangoes are doing great. And to answer the question in the chat, yes, PIBC still intend to dominate all the OSEC because we have no idea. We were going to, you know, give up like 5 or 7 regions to the new players, to the new alliance, to let some, you know, fresh stars, fresh alliances to grow, well, in a controllable manner, of course. But now CCP said they would nerf the, you know, non-sec rating, the space will be not enough, and, you know, something like that, that dynamic resource distribution. So we are scared. So fuck it. We just have everything we want. And yes, the server gets keep everything we have on there. So, and also, Panda, I will link you a private picture if you can link it somewhere else. Link it on screen. That'll be great, I think.
Sure.
Give you the. So this is what I think. This is what NetEase and CCP are up to right now. This is the picture. Can you see it?
Yeah, one sec.
So it's the program that within EVE, the CCP and NetEase would soon announce a legal way to do RMT, to trade real-life money for ISK. And of course, the CCP and NetEase would take some money out of it. This is the picture I find in a random group, not from any official of CCP or NetEase. So you can see the unit of the price is yuan. Is that means the Chinese currency. So yeah. I think they're making it for scenario.
Well, buy ISK directly from other players.
Yes, and CCP and NetEase will tax it.
And CCP taxes it.
I am 85% sure this is true. Okay, so you know.
Holy shit! That's
you
news.
Make your own judgment.
I've never seen this before.
Because okay, here's the thing. In China, if you want to ban someone, you can't do it like CCP does. Okay, since we could ban you without any, proper reason, right? I think many of you have friends has experienced that, right? Right? They don't even re reply your tickets, right? In China, that's illegal. You have to have absolutely solid proof. Okay? Otherwise, people are gonna sue you and you will have to disband that player. So if you have botting, we can have solid proof that you're botting. Like we scan your memory. That's a botting software, right? But what about the RMT? You cannot really supervising you, can you? I mean, can you do that?
No, yeah.
You can't. So you can't ban people for RMT. So you, the next best thing you
So I don't
can
want to
do,
profit from it.
yeah, you can get a profit for it, and you get a damage control. You can control the damage of RMT, right?
Yeah,
So
it's probably a
if
smart
you can,
move.
you can see that they said you moderated 7-day freeze. So if you, I that's the rumor I heard. If you sell, if okay, Fulcrum sell 1 trillion ETH to Pando, and Pando would receive it 1 week later, and the real money would be frozen, and the ETH will be frozen for 1 week. Then the GM would dig into the source of that ETH. Okay, so if that ETH come out of illegal, the player will not get ETH, and the player would get real money back. Okay, the buyer would get real money back, but the ETH would be gone for good, and the seller would be banned.
Oh,
This
well.
is not my. I have no NDA with NetEase or CCP, at least not yet. And this is in a public group, so
Yeah,
I think
you know
you.
what? I said at first I didn't see it. I think I've seen this screenshot before, but I didn't think much of it because, there's screenshots floating around all the time. And it's not my server, you know what I mean? It's like it's easy to ignore for me. But yeah, it is interesting. But for the memory scanning reasons, it's probably not even possible on our server, right? It's not like CCP can't just go in and do it here, which is like a good and a bad thing, I guess. Like, I don't want my memory scanned by anyone. So, not that I have anything to hide, you know what it is. It's just like the privacy laws. I think they're important, right? But yeah, I mean, that's quite interesting. So let's just assume there's like half a million ETH players. You know what? Like, I would 48 hours, like I would like a stream like a week straight if we had half a million people playing ETH on Tranquility. Like, I don't think I would find any time off because we would be so busy. We would be so busy killing stuff. So I can't even imagine so many players on the server. That would be something.
And CCP and NetEase is trying really, really hard to, trying to make idea to maintain all these new players. For example, we have Synarity CSM, of course. Right now we have it already. And they deemed, is that called deemed? They think, okay, determined officially that high-sec scam is illegal. So if you do high-sec scam,
ISEC
if you do high-sec contract scan, okay, you'll be banned for 7 days, then the next one will be a month, then permanently. So if you put up a scan contract in low sec or no sec, you'll be fine. But if you do it in Jita, like right now the Jita is spamming, the local of Jita is spamming with scam contract. But if you do that on Synarity from today, you'll be banned for 7 days.
Yeah, and I mean that's a unique approach. I'm not sure if that's possible. Maybe on Tranquility. I mean, technically they could do that. They could do that here, and that might just help with new player retention.
Yeah, I
And
think it
then
would.
yeah, like Gotlike says, like Tranquility gets the 500k new players all the time, but can hardly keep any of them. But that's exactly what I said earlier, right? Yeah, you can, like, we're getting 500k players, but they're spread out over such a long time that they still feel like they're getting into a game that's dominated by all these old players. While if you get 500,000 players, new players, in a very short period of time, it's going to feel more like a shit ton of new players playing this new game, for them new, right? With a couple of old players in there. But in general, it's going to have a different feel to it. So I feel like the chances for people to stick, for the 500k players that come in one big wave in a short period of time, is way higher, right? And then if you have actually those kind of things like the scam bans and stuff, it makes it a little less scary for them. And that might just get the retention up even more, right? So that's very interesting, I think.
Yeah, but we will see, right? I will stay on Tranquility, so we will see. I will tell you what happens.
Yeah, and I mean, that's another thing. You're playing on two servers, right? But, and then also for those who don't know, last week was the 1 year anniversary for Mangos, right? So congratulations to all the Mango guys. I mean, I agree 100%. You guys got quite far in that short period of time, like catching up like that. I mean, you did have the advantage of coming over with like a group that was already experienced, right? You didn't have to build player experience. People already knew how to play the game, how to make money, how to get to places, stuff like this, right? But still, like to get where you are within a year, I feel like that's quite an accomplishment. And then also, like, did you guys actually, when you moved over, did you have a set goal or something? Did you guys talk about that? Like, where do you want to get? Not necessarily fixed on a year or something, but do you feel like you did better or worse than you thought? Or what do you think? Like, did you reach the goals that you maybe set or something?
Well, that's the ultimate question, right? For an alliance. So the purpose of PIBC on Senarity and of course the Mango on Tranquility, there's only one purpose for us to survive. PIBC on Senarity has never ever started a war on Senarity. Not even one war is started by us. But yet we are dominating the server. And you think, okay, what's the back 1 year ago, the fate of Senarity is unknown. So the PIBC is a big group. So tonight, like last night, Friday night, right? We have like 2,500 players on comms, 3,000 charts in PIBC Alliance on Senarity. So there's a lot of people there. But if we need to, so back 1 year ago, we need to maintain this group, at least the core group. So we have to come over to Tranquility. Otherwise, if Senarity just died, right? And we will have nothing left, right? So when we moved on Tranquility, we were on, you know, very, very high pressure, especially my commander crew and our leaderships are on really high pressure, as you can imagine. So if I ask Initiative to move on Senarity right now, and you have to move on Senarity right now, you will have pressure because you are one of the best on this side, and you are, if you, you know, are shit on by people on the other side, you know, that will be bad for your image. People will say, okay, Initiative is not good on our case. The PIBC are built on bots, they can't fight, and shit talk will come. We will doubt ourselves. So my pressure was really high to, you know, keep the dignity of Mangos. But 1 year later, it's all gone. I don't really have any pressure now, because for now I have Senarity, you know, can always fall back on. If you remember during the tutorial war with the coalition, the problem with that was we cannot lose that war.
Yeah, right. It would have been, you know, would have been a bad situation, huh?
If we lost that war, that would be a shame on us, and we might be, you know, just, you know, fall apart. But yet we won it. But right now, even we, For example, Senarity and Norris just rise up, kill the fire, and kill the legacy. Of course, Mango was evicted to the high sec. Will we fall apart? I doubt it, because we still, this group of people still play together on Senarity. So why would we fall apart on Tranquility, right?
Yeah, I mean, that's a good point. So if anyone wants to destroy Mangos, they now have to destroy you guys on two servers, effectively.
Yeah, I would doubt that would happen. And as to the chart, you said you go through MySpace and see instant Doc Gila. Yes, I won't say that's impossible, but we are trying to control it. Please report them. Or otherwise, you can send a mail to LV223. I will report them for you. Okay? And there's no Kiki fleet on Senarity yet. People are trying really hard to rat the Triglavian, but not yet amount of Kikis could for us to form Kikimoros. But there is not many people left for us to hunt, to be honest.
You don't have enough Kikis on that server. I thought about switching, but when you said that, I'm like, can't do it.
It's only online for like 18 days now. What do you expect?
How many people did you say you have? Like, get them going, get them farming. I want to move over and do Kiki fleets. I mean, technically, all I need is an FC ship, right? So I just need to skill it to Harpy and I'm fine. And I need just a shit ton of Kiki pilots. I wonder, is that. We don't have anyone streaming from the Chinese server, do we? I never see that. Is that even allowed? Is there some barriers there?
Not on Twitch. The Twitch is banned in China. So we have like our version of Twitch. So many people are streaming there, yes? Even the Winter Coalition boys are streaming on Chinese Twitch or whatever.
All right. So it would be possible to stream. You can't just you just can't watch it from China. And since but then again, do I need an what's it called?
VPN?
Yeah, do I need a VPN to play on the Chinese server?
No, I don't think so. No, you don't. Yeah. But you need a language patch. I'm not sure if it's legal, you know, from CCP's.
I wonder. Yeah, I wonder what the rules are there. If that's possible to maybe, you know, just move over with a couple. I mean, if there's a half a million people playing on your server, I'm going to have a look. Like, I'm not going to sit here and watch it from afar. I'm going to grab some friends and have a look. Like, that's for sure. Like, I want to see Eve with half a million people playing. Like,
yeah,
I don't care about the
let's
language.
Let's hope for the best.
I'm just going to look at all the ships. I can't read the names, but I'm just going to have to look at them. And then, like, looks like a Thorax. If it's a fucking Phobos, like, tough shit. But, yeah. I mean, it would be fun, I'm sure. It would be fun to stream, too. Even though I would have to start from zero, but I guess that's just fair, is it?
So yeah, but, you know, the best of you, you know, best of Tranquility players were on Senarity do solo PvP. The, what's his name? The best you can imagine, the solo one? Okay. He make lots of videos. I can't remember his name.
The best solo PvP guy?
Yeah.
On Tranquility?
Yeah. Not Chesser, not Garmon. Who is that?
The best solo guy.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think if you would have to guess from an experience, Lucy Liu. Yeah.
Yeah, that's him. I gave him
he's the,
one
he's
of
the
my,
best guy? I don't know.
I gave him one of my high skill point character and he was streaming on Senarity.
Oh, he was streaming on Serenity already?
Yeah, but of course, 2 years ago.
Wait a second, is that even allowed? I mean, don't get anyone banned here, come on. Right.
No. He's not in China, I think. He's a Russian, right? And he streamed on Twitch. So
yeah, but you said you gave him a high skill point character.
Yeah, it's allowed on Senarity to share accounts. Of course, no one bans you. It's not allowed, but yeah. No one bans you.
I just hope nobody's getting banned for this kind of stuff. But yeah. It sounds like fun. Like 500,000 people on a server. I bet I'm not going to be the only one thinking I have to check that out. So I don't think I have to convince anyone. Right? If I tell some people like, hey, let's do this just for fun, there's going to be a couple of people jumping onto that. So yeah, expect some Kiki fleets, I guess, at some point then. If Kikis are not getting nerfed by then, please don't nerf my Kikis. But in general, like, so, but that's another thing, right? So you started a year ago here, you had experienced people, but then also you need to have, you need to train people SP-wise, but then also you have to train people up experience-wise still, right? It's still an active alliance and it will never end. Right, it's like how all like you can have the oldest alliance. You will always have like new people come in and old people leave. So like, do you have a lot of FCs that take over for on Tranquility, for example? If you are too busy on Serenity, I mean, you're not super busy, but like, would you have those guys in place? Like, who's gonna take over Tranquility if you get too busy? Right.
Well, I rarely log in the whole April, if you notice. So basically, if Lexi are not needing our help, I'm not even logging the game at all for the whole month now. I think Mango are doing good at the moment, and my FC I churned like, how to say that, 6 to 8 FCs in the last two months, and they're doing great on standing fleet. Of course, they're dedicated to roll all the drifter wormholes. I think that would be one of the main factor, because if the initiative cannot reach honest, you know, they don't need to form a fleet. If they don't need to form a fleet, they don't need a solid combat skills, right? But when I form a fleet nowadays, I will have 6 to 8 support FCs with me. So some run logi, some do damage control, some run links, some tell me their advices, you know, like something like that. Some, you know, stay on Winter Collision's calm. Sorry, I have to bring up Winter Collision because I really like them, okay? So some
obviously
give me intels. So I have all kinds of FC just going, you know, around me. I believe one day some of them will stand up to be the main FC. And nowadays, I don't need to log in the game, as I said. They do run the Mango fairly well. I mean, I don't need to really log in to run Mango. Of course, on Serenity, it was like, okay. We were, the Military Bound is our CEO, the mentor. He was really, you know, worried that someone would stand up on Serenity and, you know, be a rebellion, you know, making trouble to PIPC. But I was back on Serenity for 2 weeks or so. The biggest enemy fleet I have ever seen on Serenity for the last 2 weeks is 40 man hack fleet, and that's it. And it's a Cerberus fleet. I mean, that's all. That's all I have seen. So I think on Serenity we don't really need to worry about anything. Not
did you
for a very long time. Yeah.
Did you guys get the same patch too with the EHP of Supers and Titans, or is that's gonna come later probably, right?
Yes. That patch already hit Serenity. So basically we are 2 or 3 days later.
Oh,
the patch is
right.
2 days later than Tranquility.
So assuming there's a immense influx of new players coming in, you might just get super busy, right? And then you have people in place that can take over on Tranquility that you can count on, yeah?
Yes. Serenity is the best because PIP is so big and it's dominating, right? You can take a, you know, wild guess how big we are. So to make you understand clear, the Serenity, the PIPC of Serenity is more or less like Panfen plus Imperium, that big. Okay, and our opponents and our enemies are not as big as Lexi at all. It's only like half Lexi, not even. Not to mention the combat skills. They are nowhere to compete with Lexi's combat skills. So you can imagine how good we are, you know, on Serenity. So it's a good place to train UFC because they can lost. We can afford it. And I think even for normal people, if you lost 100 fleets, you can, you know, always stand up to be a pretty good FC. Not the best, of course, but a good FC, yes.
Yeah, and then so talking about the training part, you remember last time we talked about you telling your guys to train like lancers and projectors and bomb runs and so on. So what you told me you were doing is like you just grab a shit ton of fuel, hand it over to people, and then say, "Here, train lancers or train projectors or whatever till you run out of fuel." Right? So that's like one way to get them to train and to practice stuff. And now Shines, actually, who is like our main capital guy in it, he actually picked that up to a degree, and I believe he talked to you while he did that. He started like our Titan group, so like or restarted our Titan group, so they have to go through some sort of training to actually get in there. Which is kind of interesting, which is like people like it. It's kind of fun, right? To like, so there's like some like a couple different hurdles you have to take. You have to land something properly. You have to land some moving targets. You have to land fast enough, right? You have only so much time and all that stuff. So, and I think like he got that idea from you, right? Did you guys talk?
Yes, we talked. Yeah, obviously you two don't talk as much as we do. I told what I told you again to him. Obviously you didn't told him about what I told you. Yes,
About what?
yeah,
Like the
about
lens thing?
and the lancer thing, Titan group thing, you know, how I handpick my crew, you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah, well, the lens thing, you told me it's a secret, so I handle it as a secret, right?
Yeah, and you asked me if you can tell Darkshine or not. I said you can, but obviously you didn't talk to him. You didn't told him.
All right. I did tell him. All right, I did tell
Okay.
him. So he probably told you that I didn't tell him, but I did, right?
Oh, that's good friendship.
Yeah. He was probably worried, like, oh shit, he wasn't supposed to tell me. But no. Yeah. Like I told you right away, and I remember when we talked about it, and you told me like that little trick. But just like people that might be worried here, or they want to know, and like it's not that crazy. It's not that crazy, really. But you know that little trick. I actually told him. Oh no, I actually instantly asked you. Like you know, like I have to tell Shines, right? And you're like, yeah, okay. So yeah, that's what I did.
Yeah, it's like a how to say that.
That's
I
cool.
for I forget I forget what I want to say.
That's all right, but yeah, we'll see if lances will play any role, because I kind of feel like the situation where you would use them, it's so rare that you know, yeah, you can trade people into it, but it's more like a fun thing, really.
Yeah, it's really nice thing to see, right? It's a how to say that? It's a psychological tactic,
Oh yeah,
right?
maybe,
If
yeah.
you see so many lancers, many people just they're running a Zealot fleet and they get hit by lancer and they're so scared, you know. They when Elo Knight dodges so many lancers, people are so impressed. But I am not sure about now, but how much damage could lancer deliver to a Zealot, especially after burning one? I think it's not much at all. The boss on wood, the old boss on wood, but the lancer would never hurt man any zealot. I mean,
You know what? I'm not entirely sure about lances. How much signature you need for the lances to apply? I'm not 100% on that. But bosons, they
not
definitely don't do anything to zealots. Like that's, I mean, nothing
yeah.
significant. You're gonna, you know, there's gonna a lot of gonna be a lot of people that ADC, and then panic broadcast and stuff. So it's gonna bring chaos into the fleet. It's same with the bomb run. Like I would still bomb zealots, even though I know it's gonna not gonna deal a shit ton of damage. There's gonna be a lot of people that might just broadcast and hit the ADC just in case, and it just softens them up for another fleet to hit them. So it's sort of useless. You're just not gonna wipe them out with it, right?
Yeah. So nowadays, I won't train my people into lancers. If they can do it, do it. If they can't, well, whatever. But I will train my super carriers pilots into the projectors. They are so powerful nowadays, especially the Vendetta. On sincerity, of course, we can afford a lot of Vendettas, but not on tranquility. But I believe Initiative could afford it. Maybe take three or five. You'll be, you know, a pain for all your enemy fleets. I mean,
what's up, please, for sure, yeah.
Yeah, as you can imagine, back on Serenity, people are so desperate, okay, again, when against the PIBC. So their tactics is they use oversized afterburner. For example, they use 100 afterburner on Cerberus, on Ishtars, right? The Supers or Titans cannot track them or hit them, not in a good manner, right? So that's what how we did it. We use web projector plus newt projector to break them. So you can imagine how well I train my pilots. They can hit 100 afterburners, right?
But so would you argue that projectors may be a little bit overpowered? I mean, you like them, I know. But wouldn't you agree when I say, for example, the Vendetta web? It's, you know, it's a little bit overpowered, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's rare. For okay, I
But it
mean, I
only takes
shouldn't.
one.
Yeah, but yeah, I shouldn't have said this. But you know, back to, so how much experience on tranquility? How was my journey? Okay, here's the thing. I ask my people to chain shield supers, but there's no implant for us. So after half a year, I ask my people to chain into armor. Then I ask my people to chain into Rokkos, then the Rokko nerf. Then I ask my people to chain into Lokis, then Loki nerf. Then I ask my people to
So
chain
you're
into
saying
Nyx,
you're
then
afraid
Nyx
that now
nerf.
the fucking projectors are getting nerfed
Yeah,
after you skip?
probably. I would say projector probably will be the next.
You do know who you're talking to, right?
Yeah.
Like my shit got nerfed too. Like I know how it feels. So,
Yeah.
but if it's for the betterment of the game, you know, I'm all fine with it. And like
Even
projectors, we use them too, but if I would just whine about them, then it would come across like whining, right? So I'm not gonna even go into that, because we like projectors give us a hard time. But yeah.
then you need to train them to, you know, use them. And okay, I need to have to mention this thing, okay? Back to December, I think I pipe bombed Norris's fleet, but obviously CCP fucked up the pipe bomb too. They have the ship landed like 15 kilometers away from the Sino when you bridge it. I was so salty, you know, like, oh fuck. But yeah, CCP said it's a bug and they fixed it. Thanks, CCP.
But yeah, and for those who might not understand what we're talking about necessarily when it comes to the Vendetta and the projectors, so the Vendetta is the Serpentis super cap, right? And Serpentis always have the web bonus. That web bonus is strength, not range, like Blood Raiders or like Mimatar Tech 2 would have, but web strength. So on a Vindi, that would be a 90% web. 90% of your speed. That's a ridiculous amount of speed. And that web bonus applies to the projector. And so that means like that a Vendetta, if it hits that projector on a fleet that's anchored, everyone in that fleet that's hit, that's usually like 90% of the fleet or so, they're all 90% webbed. 90%, they're all sitting still basically. So what that not only does that mean they're getting hit now and it's like way easier to apply damage to them and all that stuff. Obviously you wanna have speed for a variety of reasons. But now also other projectors are way easier to aim because the fleet is holding still. Now you're not only webbed, you're pointed, you're neutered, you're painted, you're basically everything forever, right? So you're just sitting there floating around with nothing, pants off. And in my opinion, that's way too strong. Like way too strong, but like whatever. One
It
change at a
takes skills
time.
to hit.
It
It takes
does.
skills to hit, yes.
The problem is though, you only need one guy to hit it. And then it doesn't take any skills to hit anymore. You know what I mean? So one guy has to either have really good skills. That the thing is, it depends on the hostile fleet's speed, right? For example, let's take Kiki's as an example. It doesn't take any skill to hit that, really. If you have the basics down and you hit the projector kind of in front of it, you cannot miss, almost, right? Unless I'm turning the second you're hitting the thing, you will, your projector will be in range of us, right? It's too, like, it only has 10 seconds spool up. And in 10 seconds, we don't make enough distance to get out of the 10 km radius. So that's it. You're webbed 90%. So basically, you're sitting still. So, you know. And then God likes it. It takes no skill once you practice it. But that's what skill is. It's like, no, like with minimal practice, you will hit those on targets that are that's like around 1,000 meters per second. It's not hard to hit those. It isn't, right? If like we're not, if we're talking Munins here or 100mm ships, that's a different story. Now you need skill. Now you need to predict where they're going, and then it's way harder, right? But yeah.
Yeah, not if you have 100 nicks, right? You have 100 nicks, 50 web, 50 bubble, and I think it takes no skills to hit them, right? You know, it's a probability. In the end, you hit it.
Exactly, exactly. If you have enough tries, you will hit it. Even if it's not skill and it's just luck, you will hit it at some point. But yeah. But yeah, I would argue they're too strong. A lot of people have skilled into Superstore, so you wouldn't be the only ones that are getting hit, but you know, you're getting hit repeatedly, I guess, with the nerfs. But the main reason for that is also you're training into the strongest stuff. It would be weird if they would nerf the weakest stuff, you know what I mean? So
exactly, yes.
I guess that's alright.
A very in chat is asking, do we plan to, you know, get some more people over to Tranquil? Yeah, I think I answered that question already. Center is so boring at the moment. There's only 14 main game for you to kill, and they come like once a month, right? So what would those, you know, experienced PvPer wants to do? Of course, they want to, you know, find something to shoot, and I'll ask them to come over to Tranquility, and we have everything set up for them. Yeah, I hope that answers your question.
Yeah, and guys, if you have any more good questions, just put them in chat. We might just spot them, right? I cannot guarantee that I'll see every single one, because usually I want to pay attention to the conversation. If I get distracted, it's always like, eh, so good. That's also why I've got the sounds off for the stream alerts and stuff, right? Because it distracts me. So you have like people trained into Super Titans, and you have your guys up. Wait, where was I? You met the expectations, you think, yeah? You didn't answer that, did you?
Yes, we met the expectation. I was expecting, you know, like we survived, and now we can chill now. Especially we have seniority back online.
Your goal was just to survive.
Yes,
and you did
to
that.
Survive.
But then yeah. I would say then that would argue you went over the expectations, right?
Yes, but it was really, you know, intensive when Winter Collision declared war on us. They confirmed 500 people, and I only have 100. Of course, if you count Lexi and Fire, yes, we outnumber them. But in my time zone, I'm only on my own, right?
Yeah.
Facing them with full power, it was really scary.
Yeah, and then like, so at the beginning, and you talked about the pipe bombing and all that stuff. And then also I told people like, they might not be aware that you're actually a Rooks and Kings guy. Did you see I'm pretty sure I actually saw you on the stream when I checked in. There was a stream with CCP and Lord Maldoror from Rooks and Kings. You watched that, right?
Yes, I was all over the stream, you know?
Yeah.
For the whole session, like, I don't know, 6-7 hours?
Yeah, six and a half hours, I think it was. It looked like it looked quite fun, but I didn't have the time to watch it all. Like I checked in here and there. But like, do you think like rooks and kings are looking at coming back to any degree? Or do you?
It was breaking apart.
Do you think that rooks and kings will come back to any degree? Like, are they gonna come make a comeback and, you know, get active on tranquility again?
I think so. Eventually, yes. I can't say for speak that I can't say that for Lord Murderer, but because he has his own plan, he has a special plan for tranquility. But I'm sure sometime in the future you'll see him in the battlefield. Yeah.
All right. You know what? I just asked. You know, you never know. I didn't even expect an answer like that. I thought you were gonna say like you don't know, but like that sounds like there's some stuff in the making.
Yeah, but you know, I just accept your challenge. You remember that? Like tonight's conversation, I will make sure. I will make sure Lord Mother will be. Okay.
Yeah, for those who wonder what that is about, he actually told me that he's going to pipe on me at some point. And I'm not allowed to be mad either. And I'm not going to be. Trust me, I've been waiting for that moment for ages now. Like, I'm flying fairly low EHP configs. It's perfect to get smart bombed. But I kind of feel like we always got away. We had some close calls. I think we lost a couple dudes against GOTG once. I think that was the most successful pipe bomb actually that caught us. That was that one guy multi-boxing up in Deckline, and he caught like, I don't know, 30 maybe, 35 people out of 100 plus people. So we kind of got away with it, but so far I got lucky, I feel like. But yeah, I'm, you know what, if I'm in Ole Miss or in any, like anywhere close to you guys, I'm going to pay a little bit extra attention. Obviously. Let's hope I don't fail and get a complete whelp. Like, that's the thing about Kiki fleets too. Especially now, they're well priced, right? It's like 300 something mil for a Kiki. And if I bring like 150 Kikis, that's a couple isk. Like, if you catch that clean, oof, that's more expensive than the Munans in the video, right? That's, isk-wise, yeah. It's gonna be way more
than that. Probably.
Yeah, and it's way easier to buy a pump. Like, you don't need as many rocks. You just need like what, 5?
10?
Not even 10.
5.
Yeah, 5 are gonna do the job just fine. Yeah. We'll see. We'll see.
Yep, somewhere in the future. Yes.
But so when rooks and kings are coming back. Like, let's just say they're going to come back next week. Do you think they're going to be like as successful? Because I think since they last were on the server, it was completely different, right?
Yeah.
I mean, people are way more skilled, more intel and all that stuff. So it's, do you think they're going to be as successful? And why do you think that is?
I can't really answer that question, but I can answer you in a very different way. About the leader of Rooks and Kings, the Lord Murderer. He's a very, very special guy, okay? I think if I have ever witnessed greatness in my life, he's the one. So
holy shit.
Yeah. So for example, he's playing Forzar like several months ago, I think. He was on the top of the record. I think he holds at least one LAN of the world champion, I think. Right? He holds one record. Okay.
He holds a record in like what, in Forza?
Forza is a racing car game, I think. Yeah. And many other games. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say that or not, because sometimes it's privacy, but he holds many records in the world. He told me that if he wants to do something, he will be the best or he won't do it at all. So I think if he ever wants to come back, he will be at least one of the best, right? If you check the famous hole, right, of the, how to say that, the 3D mark, the overclocking website, the fame of Ho, for Hall of Fame, sorry. You will find his name on top of it, at least. One of the best in the world.
On 3D so, Mark? On a benchmark?
Yes, 3D Mark, yes. You can find his name. So that's it on public, so that's not privacy. I think I'm allowed to say that. So if Lord do something, he will be the best, or at least one of the best, but he will be the best, you know what I mean? So in everything I have seen him to do, for example, back to the old days, you know, when I was doing my postgraduate degree back on Australia, and I asked him to, you know, to help me to, you know, I wrote an essay, but my English is not my mother tongue. I was worried. So I gave it to him, asked him to, you know, do something about it, make it read smoother or like native speaker. That essay get full mark, as you can imagine.
that dude got away with words, I have to give him that. I've never talked to him though, so I don't even know him.
Yeah, so he was one of the best university in Australia. So he can get a full mark. You know how impressive was that to me, right? That you can't fake that, because that's my essay. I handed it to the professor and the professor gave me back with a full mark. I have never, you know, seen a full mark in my life. So you can feel how great he is, at least how good he is in my mind. So to answer your question, if he ever decides to come back, he will be one of the best for sure. There's no question about it, in my opinion, of course.
Yeah, but then in Eve, what does the best mean, right? So then you're going to have Mittens claim the throne, because he is the best, he has the most influence. Then you're gonna have probably Aerith do the same, right, his right hand industry guy. Then you're probably gonna have Vili and who knows what, like all kinds of people. Then you have like solo guys like claim it, because they like, so he might just be the best, but in a very specific area, right? And that's what, that when someone says Rooks and Kings, that's what I'm thinking about. They're the best at one specific part of it, right? Because I would say politically, or like in Eve, like from the landscape, it wasn't that much influence coming from Rooks and Kings, I would say, right? Like Nullsec, beside the like maybe a campaign to like morale wise to have him on your side would have been always great, obviously. But in general, I don't think, you know, it was that much influence. So how do you measure who's the best? And that's the question. So you'll never be able to actually claim it 100% here. So.
Yeah, it is in a certain way you can say, well, who is the best, who is not. Because the empire dies, all the empires dies, right? And they end. But something will be permanent. For example, even Rooks and Kings stopped playing for like half a decade now, right? Many people are still talking about them. When Lord Mordor hop on stream and there was 1,000 people watching it, right? Yeah. Even half a decade. I mean, Eve is only like 15 years, 16 years, right? Like, a third of the time Rooks and Kings is inactive and people are still crazy about them. I would say that's a sign of one of the best alliance or group of people in Eve, right? Of course, you can't say people are good and bad in, you know, different areas. You can not really say someone is the best. For example, if you say, okay, Mitten is the best, okay, I can always bring up Senarity, right? The mentor will be the best because mentor dominates all, and the argument keeps going, right? There's no certain way to say someone's the best. But if we take a vote, I would say most of the people would like Rooks and Kings more than, I mean, Goons, right?
So, and, so the thing is, though, you could always make that argument saying Rooks and Kings, like, they...
Make the best video.
Exactly. Yes. So, yeah, I think that's like marketing wise, and like it's easily likable. I mean, it's like good stuff, you know. It's like obviously everyone's gonna like it, but like inferential in the game, I would argue that's probably not the case then, right? But I would love to see him come back and then, you know, come in with some good shit. I mean, consider you called out, Lord Maldoror. Bring it on, right? So it would be good to see something different. I think we actually need that too. Maybe he can start, you know, with rooks and kings and drag some people out of coalitions and stuff. Make an example of like, look, you can live outside coalitions, which we, you know, might not see, like ways to, you know, live. Who knows? And, you know, maybe he's a good candidate for a future FC chat, I would say, right? I'm not sure.
Yes.
How open. If I would have known that he's open for that kind of stuff, I would have like loved to have him on.
He's mostly not. He's doing it only for coronavirus, I think. Of course, only my opinion. He never told me why he willing to, you know, hop on CCP's stream. But if you be friend with him, he will be one of your best friends, I think. You know, his mind is really deep, and his way to, you know, do things and think about things is really, really, you know, interesting, I would say.
Creative, which I love, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you know what? The video making part, that's kind of stuff that, like, I want to learn. I actually want to get into some video making and stuff like this. But I think people, and we talked about that last time with Ultra Cow, for example. He's doing videos for Goons. And I think it's underappreciated that, like, people that make videos, proper videos, I'm not saying these, like, 5 times sped up kind of weird videos, but, like, proper edited storytelling kind of videos, right? I think they're underappreciated and people don't understand how much work goes actually into that and how much impact videos like that can have on, like, morale and so on, right? So, like, I really want to kind of get into that kind of stuff.
Yeah, so. I'm making an annual Mango video. Okay, I promised them I will make a year per year. That's a promise from me to Mangoes. Okay, so we have PIBC 2015, 16, 17, 18, and so on. So now it's that I should have released PIBC 19 like 3 months ago. People are, you know, trying to kill me, you know, for the absence of the video. But I'm making it for, I would say, more than 2 months now. I'm only halfway down. You know what I mean?
Yeah, if you want to do it proper, it takes time. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. And it takes time, not during the production part, but you have to collect all the material. You have to tell your story, right? I mean, in EVE, every alliance have their story every year. I believe Initiative has, right? The Goons has, Test has, every alliance has. But you have to have someone. You have to have someone to collect all the, you know, files. That's so precious. So for me, I record every single thing happened on my PC. So when I go into my TeamSpeak Chinese comms, I record every single sentence so that in the production part, I can always, you know, take them out. There's some, you know, really funny and gold times that I can take out and put in the annual video, and the people are really like it. You know what I mean? Like someone says something really funny, but most of the time they just lost in time. You know, you don't have it recorded, and they just waste it. And many years later, you have nothing to, you know, recall. But I made it different. I record everything. So in the end, I just take out those precious parts and put them together and make it the annual video.
You know what? Sorry. Yeah.
It's really, you know, you have to dedicate it into it. Like, you know, in Mangoes, that when you say something wrong, now they will say, okay, you are making it to annual video now. You know, like when, okay, here's the thing. It was fun when Initiative or Norris or Thera guys or the Volta visited Ormist, because someone will get caught. and that someone will shit their pants. If you record how those people shit their pants and play it back when they calm down to them, it was so fun. You know, like I have several of that kind of video. You can, you know, like really like feel their panic. Ask, okay, are you killing the cyano inhibitor? He'll say, yeah, I'm killing it. Okay, then 30 seconds later, ask, okay, how what's the status of the cyano inhibitor? He said, okay, I'm in 10% shield. I lost 10% shield. I said, the cyano inhibitor. He said, yes, I lost 10% shield. I'm in hell. You know, that kind of, you know, shit on pants details. That's really good.
There's a really good like an old story from Dark Giants, actually, who is our capital, Mane of Sea. And there's this video where he jumps in as Moloch to bait a PL Dreadbomb. A lot of people might have seen it here. And the PL Dreadbomb, first of all, that video is fucking ace. Like, I might just play this at the end. But so the story is, he jumps in, baits with the Moloch. We were very aware what was happening or about to happen. They jump in 100 Dreads to kill his Moloch, right? But we had everything ready. So we jump all our supers in as a response. But before we did that, he lights the Cyano and calls in faxes and everything. But then Bliss steps in, who is another main FC, right? And he says, like, no, don't jump yet. Like, he didn't know there's already 100 Dreads on grid shooting his Moloch. And then one of UFC says, no, don't jump faxes in. Because he thought, like, oh, let's bait in everything. Because he thought it's just a couple thing. And then you could hear Shine's voice, like, super high-pitched, speaking up, no, jump everything in. And it was just such a funny moment. I think someone recorded it, too. But obviously, the video that he made, that wasn't in there. But, yeah, it's like, some of those moments, you know, it's just a shame that they get lost sometimes, right? And it's great if you can record them.
Yeah, so even now I visit the video I made 5 years ago. There's so many, you know, gold moments that I will remember for the rest of my life, I think. It was so sweet, yeah.
You know what? Also, like, shout out to everyone who is, like, out there making those videos for whatever group you're in, right? I think Volta did a great job on the last ones. I think I played one of the Volta videos when I had, was it Motherfuckers that I had on? Not sure who it was. One of the Volta guys that was on. I played a video of theirs. Really well done, really good. And you know what? As an FC, I can tell you right now, like, sometimes you don't feel like logging in and doing all kinds of shit and, like, talking to everyone and all this stuff. It gets too much sometimes, right? But what gets me always back in the mood is, like, just watching a couple old videos, you know? Like, yeah, that was actually quite nice. And, you know, if it's well done, it really you know, gives me some energy sometimes, which is great. And you know what? What do you think about, like, so you record all the footage, right? But the problem also when you make a video, you want to make it extra great, you don't have all these angles. Right, like, for example, that pipe bomb, it's one guy's camera. Like, I'm not sure, it was your recording, I guess. Did you record that one? I guess, yeah.
No, it was my view. No,
it wasn't. But in general, like, it's always that one guy who records it, and then you can't really, you don't see at every from every angle, really. I mean, he did a great job in that one, and it zoomed out a little bit, and, like, it looked great and shit. But at the same time, wouldn't it be awesome if you had, like, the same fight from all kinds of perspectives? So what I thought is, like, why don't you have, like, several people record it? Right? For example, put some guidelines out there, like, how people should record it, like, what quality and stuff like this, right? And then maybe, that's what I thought I'm going to do maybe at some point, put out a list of shots that you're looking for. Let's just say a normal, like, subcap to capital to super capital engagement, like escalation chain. Like, that's the kind of fight you kind of want to record from more than one angle. You want to see, like, a scene where the Dreads are shooting each other. You want to see the scene where the Cyano is lit and then the Titans jump in, or you want to see the Cynolids and the Dreads jump in and all that stuff. So you want to have those different scenes and then have a list of those, like what people should be looking for. And then instead of having one guy trying to get all that recorded, you can have like 10, 15 guys trying to record it. And then you have a way better chance of getting really good shots, right?
Yeah, the pipe bomb clip you just showed, I have in my drive have 6 versions of it, totally different people recorded, and include my view. You know, my view is in a dictator, so it was kind of boring. So, because I make annual video, so it's a habit in Mango that every fleet of mine would have like at least 3 people are recording it. They and then after the fight, they would just send it to me, so that I can have a different perspective of the fight.
Yeah.
And of course, I always record the enemy comms. For example, on Chun quality, the most I have is Norris' voice. Okay, he's like my boyfriend, you know what I mean? His voice is stuck in my head right now because I'm making the video. I have to listen to him like all day long, his meetings, his FCs, something.
That's funny. Yeah, I hope, like, if you catch me with a pipe bomb, I expect a video with my comms, right? I'd be disappointed if that's not in there.
No, I won't let you know, because the panicking part of the enemy is the best part. If you know it, if you know I am recording, you will not panic. You will be very happy. Then the pipe bomb video won't be sweet, you know what?
Well, I will not think about that. Like, the second I get pipe bombed, I don't think I would instantly say, like, oh, I have to act like all cool because, like, I end up on a recording otherwise. I don't think that would be the first thought in my mind. But at the same time, I don't see me panic. I've been waiting for this so long. Like, honestly, like, I'm surprised it didn't happen yet. So,
yeah, I have two good spy stories. One is the end of REC. There were only 8 people. If you have watched the Rooks and Kings video, the Leaf King Leaf Queen ask everyone to fall on their swords, destroy their charts, destroy their assets. There were only 8 people, including the Leaf Queen, in REC's final meeting. So there were only 7 people are not Leaf Queen, and one of them is me. So you can imagine how deep my spy into them. And the other one is most of my spy end up, get burned, not because I, carelessly, burn them, but their cop join Mango and they become friendly. That's right. How I most
Why
of my
didn't you
spy
just jump ship then, with the spy saying like, no, I hate Mangos, and you just switch and nobody would have suspected that, right?
Yeah,
I mean, that would have been a good reason to switch.
Yeah, but I have enough spies in the end, so I don't really need to worry about that. So Norris kicked one of my FC spy like 2 days ago, like the day before yesterday. It was, I think, 12 or 14 of his character get kicked in like 4 or 5 different corporations within Winter Coalition. So you can imagine, how my FC crews do the spicing. That's just one of them. One of us, I think.
Yeah. Spies. I wish there was no spies in this game. To be quite honest, that would be great for the game if there was no spies at all. But it's like, that's not the reality, right? So,
yeah.
Everyone has to play that game, the spy game. And we're struggling with it a little bit at the moment. I have to be quite honest, like, everyone gets our pings, everyone gets, it's so annoying. I mean, you come with me all the time, right? Like, saying, like, hey, like, I saw your ping, what are you doing? Or, same for fucking Noros. He comes with me, like, I'm hunting at, like, your time zone. You guys are, like, instantly. Was it you or was it Noros where I said, like, guys, we have to talk at some point? It's like, it's getting ridiculous, right? I combo, and then one of you says, like, hey, we want to hunt together. The other one says, like, oh, are you gonna go hunt here? We're going red. And I'm just sitting there thinking, ah, oh, damn it. All right.
Yeah, me and Norris, I will say, I won't say we hate each other. I think he doesn't like me, but in the end, your enemy is your best friend, right? They know better. They know
I
you
don't
better
know.
than your friend. There was one fight about spy, really interesting. It was in 3-0 in Smother. Why I think it's really funny? Because I talk on my comms and Norse talk on his comms and we're talking to each other. Can you imagine that? So he has a
I had
spy
that
in my
before too.
on my comm and I have spy on his comm. So when he switch to chamber, I'll say, oh, I say, okay, Norris switch to chamber. Then we switch to chamber. And when he switched back to the fusion, I say, okay, let's switch back to fusion. And we laugh on our comms, you know, together, you know, like on different comms, but at the same time, he and me both laughed, you know, like it was a really funny moment that two FCs listen to each other, you know. Yeah,
Yeah,
that
you
kind
know,
of thing.
I did have someone on comms and he like reacted to what I said. I actually didn't have a spy on their comms. Like that's rare. I'm not sure if that ever happened before. But yeah, must be quiet. I mean, you two have such a long history now. Imagine those 500,000 people coming in, the new people, and then they start com something completely new, and you both are, you know, being targeted basically. I mean, he is not active on Serenity at the moment, right?
Not at all. He never plays on Serenity at all.
Yeah, but like, imagine though, if he would, and then suddenly, like, there's this wave of new player, and then like, all these old players have to actually band together to have a chance because it's so many. That would be too funny. And then suddenly, you guys are best friends.
Yeah, the funny thing is, I have been too long to be the enemy with him. You know, sometimes I wish I'll be the friend with him. I always imagine, you know, how that turns out. You know what I mean? The first, you know, sometimes you find your enemy is really good and you have this kind of feeling that you wish that you're on his side. Even on Serenity, we killed everyone. Sometimes I just wonder, you know, I wish I could be the friends with REC. You know, I wish I was on their side. I wish I was, you know, really in their crew, but well, it would never happen, I think.
And that's weird. I don't think I ever thought that, to be quite honest.
Yeah,
But then
well,
again, I don't have an enemy, a direct enemy like you do, right? Like,
yeah,
we do have
he's.
kind of the collision wise, it's kind of there in CPL maybe, right? Like Headliner, for example, I had a Headliner on. He's like PL and Innit, they have a long history. But at the same time, like I never saw Headliner as like my, you know, direct enemy or something. So when he was on, like we were super friendly, like you know, it just happens to be on. We just happen to be on different sides, right? So I can totally see us working together. But as long as I'm in it and he's PL, that's, you know, we're not gonna work together. So yeah, I get what you mean, but I think it's a different story probably for you guys because you have such a long history and it's such a, you know, like your arch enemies, really, right?
Yeah, I won't call it that way. I don't know where that come from. You know, like I was sitting in peaceful almost, but Norris declared war on me, and he lost the war, and he disliked me, not hate me. He disliked me. I don't know where that come from, but yeah. Anyway.
But isn't that good for the game though? A little bit, like I don't want to say hate, but a little bit of like a grudge. That's good for the game, isn't it? I think
Yeah.
we're missing that. And nowadays, like in today's Eve, we could use way more of that. Rivalry is the perfect word for it. Yeah, we
Yeah,
could use more of that.
it makes you work for an extra mile. A quote from Lord Maldron, right? It makes you to, you know, get up in the morning. It makes you know, talk to people in the middle of the night. That's, you know, people need even need that, yes. And people asking the best called the spy true story. Yes, I have one for you. Like half a year ago, when Winter Coalition declared war on us, they prepared a big Jett bomb. I would say 50 to 70 Jetts were locked off within range of Ormist. So how did I call it? I can't reveal my spy, of course. We caught their spy, How did I do that? I have a spy in their core dread group, which is like 50 people, including Norris himself in it. But I have spy in it. I have 3 spy in that group. But yeah, anyway, so they moved the spy to us. They moved the dread bomb to us, and they set a day. It was a Monday afternoon. They gonna dread bomb us before the DT. Everything is set up, and of course I know it, and we were preparing for it. Sorry, it's too early in the morning now. So we prepared for it, and nothing happened in the end. Why? Because one of their spy typed on our comm screen, said Mango has 10 Faxis pilots online. It's unusual.
He put it in the wrong channel.
He put it on the wrong channel. So the whole mission was burned. We did nothing wrong, but their spy did something wrong, and no one gets anything.
So yeah, you guys were ready anyway, but their spy fucked it up, so they didn't drop because they knew then that you knew, even though you knew anyway. It's like, Oh my god.
They knew that I knew, and I knew it anyway, so yeah.
Yeah, we had someone actually, so we formed up to take a fleet into a wormhole where Hartnox was busy evicting someone or something. I forgot what exactly it was, but we were on the way, and then someone on comms suddenly spoke up. He's like in a funny way, he's like, ha ha ha, I'm like on 3 different comms, and like Init is doing this and this, and you know, it's like wrong comms, dude. Like, it was so obvious that he wasn't supposed to say that. I'm not 100% sure if it was actually a spy. I would say the chance is 99%, so we kicked him, obviously, right? But it's the kind of stuff, right? Spies being so busy in like so many different channels, and then they push the wrong key, and that's it. So, you know, spy is burned. Happens quick.
Yeah.
If he was a spy, he's not anymore. That is true. Or maybe he is, just with another account. Who knows? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, and then talking about Walmart space. So, for those who wonder how these FC cards, how we do these, right? I always send out a little, what do you call it? Now, basically, you guys have to fill it out for me, right? Because it's not like we are, or I'm raiding someone, like, for example, how good he is at fighting, theory crafting, or leadership. It's like time spent on, and I don't know how much time people spend on stuff. And sometimes there's a couple surprises in here, right? For example, in your case, area of operation, I didn't know you were in Walmart space that much. So, like, what does that mean? Like, you've got 5 points in Walmart space and only 8 in Nullsec. So, like, how does that come to, like, is that a lot of Walmart space activity on Serenity? Or what is
that? Give me a second. Just give me a second, okay?
Yeah, don't worry.
So, I'm back. Yeah, yeah. We don't have a lot of wormhole space, but I have probably one of my best friend, probably the best friend. Okay. His name is Romoto. He was on Tranquility. Okay, his English is perfectly good. I mean, perfectly good. Okay, he was on Tranquility, but he find it. I don't know the reason, but he moved to the Serenity, and in the end, he was on the verge of Claps Alliance. I think, right? I think yeah. Volta, the main cop of Volta was on. In the verge of collapse, right?
Yeah, I think
they were one of the best wormhole alliance on Tranquility, right? So Romoto go back to Serenity and built up his own verge of collapse, and it was one of the best. Okay, one of the best, probably the best, PvP wormhole alliance. Okay. But Remoto is a successful man in real life. I mean, really successful man. So he sometimes has to disappear from Eve and go back to real life. Okay, he makes great movies, real life movies. I believe many of you have heard it, but due to privacy issue, I can't really tell you which movie he made, but one of the most famous Chinese movie, he was part of it. So in the end, he has to take a leave. So I'm his best friend, so I have to take care of his alliance. But his alliance was in Wormhole, and mine is in Nosec. There's nothing more I can help him. So his alliance fell apart during his absence, and he's not blaming on me. But the people who forced his alliance to fall apart, called Star Chaser. Star Chaser was on Tranquility too, I think. They get absorbed by fraternity, so no more Star Chasers, no more. Okay.
Wait a second, they're getting observed by fraternity,
absorbed. So they're people merging into fraternity.
Oh, absorbed. So, all right. Yeah, okay. So, I get it.
Okay, so when Yomoto came back, his alliance doesn't exist no more. But he's one of the best PvPer I have ever seen, and he's my friend, right? Of course, I can take him in. So the famous Lancer Squad, the whole serial crafting, the whole discovery of that weapon is all on him. He's not on charge of training my pilots, but he's the one who created the Lancer Squad. So you can imagine how good he is. And he's my right hand to run any kind of Pi Bomb. Okay, all my Pi Bomb campaign, except the Elo Knight one. The Elo Knight one, he's not there because he's busy in real life. But he joined me like months after that. So his alliance got destroyed by Star Chaser. So we have to take revenge on it, because I am a vindictive people, vindictive guy. Okay, so I have to, because on Sinerity was so strong, so there's no reason for me not to take revenge on Star Chaser. So Star Chaser placed the very first keep star on Sinerity, which is in a wormhole. To kill a wormhole keep star is not an easy thing. So after I think Initiative killed the first one, right? Or the first one on Tranquility, right? Or
yeah,
it's like
Arnox,
right. So a month or 2 months after you killed the Harnox one, we killed the Star Chaser one. Killed the Star Chaser keep star just to,
I think You know what? I think you actually killed that keep star first. You sure?
I think we killed it in the 1st October 2017, I think. When you checked list.
No, I think you killed it early 2018, I'm pretty sure. So what I think I remember is we were prepared and ready to go, but we were still in a war. Right? That's what people forget. When they when the news articles and stuff are written, they always like this part when they said it was a year-long preparation. Yeah, there's reasons for that, right? First of all, we had to test how it works. Then we had to get going. And then also we had a war to fight first, right? There was a massive war going on with X-47 and all that stuff happening, right? And then after that war, we had to take a little bit of a break, and then we did it. But while we were actually ready to go, everything was in place. You guys did that on Serenity. I do remember that. I think you guys did it first on Serenity. And we were they're doing it first. It's kind of weird, right? The parallels were so weird. I'm pretty sure you guys did it shortly before we did.
Yeah, did, but we did it after Harnox. Harnox killed Keepstar the 15th July 2017. We killed it October. Yeah.
Oh, that's true. Actually, there was a Keepstar there, but
So yes, That comes back to your question, or your hate against spy. PIPC is so huge. I mean, it's Plan Van plus Imperium, big. Okay, 3,000 people in game, and 2,5 thousand people on comps. There's not a single way you can avoid the spies, right? So Star Chaser must have spies in us. That's inevitable. So anytime, every time I ping a fleet, Star Chaser will just collapse the hull. So we back to the ground zero. What I have done there was I ping a force fleet. Like I make a timer in HiSec. Then I ping a fleet for HiSec ops. So the Star Chaser wasn't alert. Then we, you know, spawn in. We get like 15 material inside their manhole gradually, you know, like within 2 weeks time.
Yep. CD,
and and we made a war on I can't say I made a war, but I asked for help to create a war on Tranquility, because at that time Star Chaser was on Tranquility and you know, having a war with Test. So I asked Test, okay, can you bring on a big fight? So that was the F-QQ fight. The Test, you know, didn't know who the fuck I am, but Test said, okay, we'll see what we can do, but you know, no really any answer. But when the time comes, Tesla made a timer and dropped the supers and dropped jets. So at that night, I getting like 20 or 30 Macarios in the hole. Then in October 1st, I think, I ping for a HiSec ops. Then I get my fleet to the entrance. I think Star Chaser noticed that, so I ask all the people in the wormhole to log in and control the hole. Then we're getting like 150 ferrocs, and that will be the end of Star Chaser keep star. So we control the hole, we roll more people in, we control the hole more solid, then we roll more people in.
Yeah,
so in the end we kill the keep star with the help of Romoto, and he was so happy. I mean, He's so happy about that. You can feel the, you know, satisfaction, right? Someone killed your alliance, then in the end you killed.
Yeah, I can. You know what? It's a similar thing as Ari, who's my right hand, like assist basically, or like, you know, support FC, and she was a long time wormholer, and then when we evicted Hard Knocks, like, that was pure happiness, right? Like, obviously she worked hard for that one too, so like I can like, it's probably pretty similar, right? And you must have felt accomplished too, right, when you kill like a thing like that. It's tough and it takes some time and commitment.
Yeah, not really satisfaction from killing Star Chaser, but from the, you know, love and satisfaction phase from Remoto, I get satisfaction from that, to be honest.
That you could make it right for your friend.
Yeah, and I make a video about it, and he's so happy. And he was on Tranquility helping me, but I think recently he's you know, going back to real life stuff. I haven't seen him for a week or two, I think.
I think he was in chat earlier. Roboto88? I'm not sure if that's his Twitch name, but he was talking.
Probably, I think.
Yeah, I something.
Yeah.
There he is. Star Chaser is Fraternity.
Oh yes, he's here.
All right. Well, no, that's an interesting you know, story. I mean, friendships, they form quite quite fast. I wouldn't say fast actually, but like friendships that build over Eve, like they can be strong, right? Like, I've got like some really good friends, like for example Dark Shines, right? Really good friend of mine, so I can totally see the parallels there. And
it's an interesting experience. There's one more story about me and Muramoto. So back to, like, it was like 5 years ago. I was playing StarCraft with him. I was a shitty player in StarCraft, so he was really angry about me, you know, being shit. But we were playing, and at that time his alliance still exists and leaving wormhole and still leaving a, you know, pathetic pause. So one of his crew got caught on the sun with a jet. Can you imagine? So we were playing the StarCraft, so that guy, you know, shit on his pants and come on comms, said, "Oh, I'm gonna need help," or something like that. So me and Remoto were logging the charge and rapier. Okay, so we just a jet, a charge, and a rapier. So there was like a 16-man gun in a 16-man shield tank battle cruiser gun in an armor tank class 5 wormhole. So you can imagine the outcome. We intentionally lost one ship so that they can all show on the kill board.
I'm not entirely sure if I can follow that story. Like, why is there like a shield gang and an armor wormhole? Like, I'm confused as shit.
Because they are roaming and they find a jet on the sun. They didn't think, so they catch it and they ping everyone and ask them to come in. And I was playing StarCraft with Remoto, so we have to disconnect StarCraft and connect to Eve to save someone in Eve. You can imagine that we're jumping around the world. You know, that's interesting experience.
I had that a good few times, actually. Shines and I play in like something like PUBG, or be it Overwatch, or be it... I never played StarCraft with Shines, but we played a shit ton of different games. And then sometimes someone hops onto comms and says like, "Oh, like, you guys, like, can you form or whatever?" And then we're like, "Do we have to form?" And then we ask questions like, "All right, where is that Nyx? Like, is he tackled by... Like, who is tackling it? What is it on grid?" And we just consider forming. And we had that not too long ago, actually, and then it turns out it was a friendly Nyx that was tackled, but it wasn't in range, and we're like, "Yeah, might just finish this round and hope for the best," and it was actually saved. A lot of times, Blurkers, who was on comms actually earlier, Blurkers would then form and save it, so I'm grateful to have him around. But yeah, that's like, yeah, I can see all the parallels, actually. We also play StarCraft, actually. That's why Corky is like, "What the fuck, StarCraft?" Panda makes us play StarCraft. Yeah, I sometimes do. It's a fascinating game.
It is. It helps you to, you know, control the... You know, it helps you to train your strategy skills. You know, sometimes you can chase things. For example, in StarCraft, I was a, you know... how to say it, Warcraft guy. You know, I played Warcraft for a very long time, but now I'm more into StarCraft because of Eve. So StarCraft, the thing in StarCraft are all expandable. Even the battlecruiser, that huge one, is a expandable unit, right?
Yeah.
So that Eve, that changed my perspective to play Eve. So the great mind things are like, after I talked with Remoto, we had this evil plan to shred all kinds of shield supers. I'm sorry, Test. I'm sorry, Vili. I have to say this because everyone gets nerfed, right? So how to shred a shield capital fleet? It was supposed to be kept in secret, but since the nerf of EHP is useless from now on, I think. So you get Newt in your high slot and Ethan Burst in your mid slot for all armor shield, armor super carrier, for example, the Eon and the Nyx. The Eon itself would have like 60 to 80 million EHP. And in most of the fight, super carriers are useless, right? I think most people would agree with it. In most of the super capital fight, the X-47, UALX, I think super capitals are useless, totally.
Well,
right?
Not totally. We used them to tackle their Titans and Supers because they could have redocked and tethered and shit like this. We had to jump them on 1-0.
Yes. So we jumped our... Of course, this is on test mode, a test server mode. No one would dare to challenge PIBC on Xenarity. So we jumped like 200 armor tank super carriers at on top of the enemy Titans fleet. So what they can do is they put nukes on the Titans, especially shield Titans. So every 30 to 50 would be a wing. A wing of super carriers could Newt out a Shield Titan instantly. Then we just swap our Titan's gun to the Shield Titan, which is Newted out. That means I have 5 supportive FC who is running their own Newting fleet and would report to me which Shield Titan is totally dried out. Then we just swap our gun to it. It was simply alpha that Titan, and then we go back to our normal target. That's the way we do it. So that makes all our whole supercarrier fleet expandable but useful, right? Much more useful than just you know, stay with my Titan fleet and shield it, because I think defend job you can always give it to the normal carriers, right? You don't need a supercarrier to defend.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's interesting. I mean, people have always said like the weakness of shield supers on Titans would be getting neutered out, hardeners are off and stuff. But at the same time, if you only have that one primary, it's way easier to also have faxes cap it up. So it's very hard to neut against all the faxes giving it cap. But if you spread it out, like you said, I can totally see Titans being dry completely, that you can then switch to, right? And then they can't do anything about it. They can't cap up everyone, right?
And you can't kill. Yeah. And you cannot kill my supers because they're 60, 80 million EHP. They're as good, as tanky as the Erebus.
Yeah. I think.
And plus, you have ESM Burst. That will work on Titan.
Yeah, but I mean, the chance of success is so low. But if you bring enough,
if you bring 200, chance will be 80%, I think.
Yeah. But at the same time, you're getting ECM Buster too, but you have to bring ECCM, I guess.
No, it doesn't matter because the newt works in a weird way. You click the button and you newt the target.
You only have to have lock for a second and that's it.
Yeah.
All right, I agree, yeah. You know what, that's another thing. Maybe newts shouldn't work like that. They shouldn't have such a long cycle time, but just work in one tick, you know? I don't know. Maybe that's too hard for the server. Even though it doesn't make sense either, right?
Yeah, it doesn't make sense at all.
Depends on the size. But yeah, I mean, that's interesting, right? That's like the theory crafting stuff that I love to dive in when the situation comes, right? When a war kicks off, and this is the kind of stuff we have to fight, then yeah, I'll think about that for sure. But yeah, you know what? We are well over 2 hours, and usually I just aim for 2 hours, and you've been staying up too, so I feel a little bit bad.
I'm all good. I play StarCraft with Remoto. You know, this time is a regular StarCraft time.
Well then, I would say thanks again for coming on a second time too. Interesting to hear the whole Serenity stuff and all that stuff. And yeah, much appreciated.
No worries, it's a pleasure, to be honest. Yes, it's truly a pleasure to talk to you. Because it's really any, you know, good FCs left. And those who doesn't hate me is more, so it's always, you know, good to talk to a good FC.
What other FC that hates you though? You know?
Well, I mean, Elon Knight, that probably doesn't want to talk to me for the rest of his life, I think, right?
Oh, what? Why? Because of that one pipe bomb?
Yeah, probably.
Nah.
Because
that's not how he works. He's going to be mad in a moment. But he's going to be fine the next day. Like, I hardly think he remembers that one. But yeah.
Okay.
All right. And the guys on stream, yeah, if you have any super great question right now, I might just be able to ask it. But other than that, I would say thanks a lot for watching and hanging out, guys. But let's see who can host. Any suggestions, guys? And I would say I just host someone. Who's on? Let's see. Corvus, he's doing some PvP. How about him? Or do we have someone super fresh? and see. That seems to be PvE. Yeah. Let's just host Corvus, guys. And then again, thanks a lot for watching. If you want to get notified, join the Discord. And other than that, yeah. See you guys around. And bye.
Bye.